Hey everyone! Welcome back to integralcalc.com. Today we're going to be talking about finding the sum of a telescoping series. And in this particular problem, we've been asked to find the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of 1 divided by 4n squared minus 1. And with any telescoping series and finding the sum of a telescoping series, what you're going to want to do is perform a partial fractions decomposition on the fraction that you've been given for your sum. So that means that we're going to want to factor our denominator as much as we can. So if we factor our denominator, 4n squared minus 1, we'll find that it's equal to 2n plus 1 times 2n minus 1. And remember to perform a partial fractions decomposition. We're going to set this fraction equal to a divided by the first term in the denominator on the left, so 2n plus 1, and then we're going to put b over the other term. So we'll add, and then we'll get b over 2n minus 1. And now we're going to want to multiply both sides by the denominator from the left-hand side. So we're going to multiply this whole thing by 2n plus 1 times 2n minus 1. And as you can tell, what that's going to do is cancel the entire denominator over here on the left. So we'll just be left with 1 equals. For the term that involves a here, the 2n plus 1 is going to cancel with this 2n plus 1. And we'll be left with a times 2n minus 1. And then for the second fraction with b, the 2n minus 1 will cancel with 2n minus 1. And we'll be left with b times 2n plus 1. Now it's just a matter of simplifying this equation and then developing a system of simultaneous equations that we can solve for the coefficients a and b. So we're just going to want to multiply things out here, and we'll get 2an minus a plus 2bn plus b. And I didn't need that parentheses there. And then we'll go ahead and group our terms together. So we'll say 2an plus 2bn. We're grouping those together because they both have an n to the first power variable involved with them, right? These two n's. And then we're going to group together negative a and positive b because neither of those terms have an n variable involved. They are the constants in this equation. So now we'll go ahead and factor out the n. So we'll get 2a plus 2b. We're just factoring out the n, so we pull that out there, plus negative a plus b. So now we can equate coefficients on the left and right-hand sides, and hopefully you'll remember this from partial fractions. But basically on the left-hand side, we have 0n plus 1, right? There's no n term, no term that involves the variable n on the left-hand side, so we have 0n plus 1. 1 is the constant. 0n is the first degree term. So because the coefficient over here on the left on the n term is 0, that means that the coefficient on the n term on the right hand side has to equal 0. So we grab those two and we say 2a plus 2b must be equal to 0. And then similarly, because the constant on the left is equal to 1, that means that the constant on the right, negative a plus b, must also be equal to 1. So we'll say negative a plus b equals 1. So now let's go ahead and solve this system of simultaneous equations. We'll take this second equation and we'll add a to both sides to find that b is equal to 1 plus a. Now we can take this value, 1 plus a, and plug it in for b into our first equation. So we'll find 2a plus 2, and here's where we'll make our substitution for b of 1 plus a, and that's going to be equal to 0. So now we can multiply out, we'll get 2a plus 2 plus 2a equals 0. We'll find that 4a equals negative 2, and therefore that a is equal to negative 1 half. Now that we know that a equals negative 1 half, we will plug that into this equation for b, and we'll get b equals 1 minus 1 half. Therefore, b is equal to positive 1 half. So we can note these two solutions for the constants A and B. So once we have those solutions, now that we're finished with our partial fractions decomposition, we can go ahead and plug them back in to this part of our equation right here, and this is what we'll use to determine the series. So we'll plug in negative 1/2 for A, so we'll get negative 1/2 over 2n plus 1, and then B is 1/2, so we'll get plus 1/2 divided by 2n minus 1. And let's go ahead and flip these around so that we're not leading with a negative. We'll end up with 1/2 over 2n minus 1 minus 1/2 over 2n plus 1. So now this is our series. We'll call this S sub n. And what we want to do is go ahead and start plugging in a value for n. So we've already been told in our problem that we need to start with a value of 1 when we plug in for n. So that's what we're going to do. We're going to say the sum of the series is going to be equal to, and we're going to start writing out terms. Obviously, this is an infinite series, so we can't write out every term, but we're going to write out the first few to just give us an idea of what the series is starting to look like. So let's just say that we're plugging in 1 for n. Here in our first term, and we're going to plug it into this whole series here. So in this first one, we'll get 1/2 divided by 2 times 1 minus 1 minus 1/2 over 2 times 1 plus 1. So as you can see in the bottom here, we're going to get 1. So that's going to be 1/2 over 1, which is just 1/2. And over here in our second fraction, we'll end up with 3. In the denominator, 1/2 divided by 3 is going to be 1/6. So that means that our first term is going to be 1/2 minus 1/6. So you can call this n equals 1. Now if we go ahead and plug in 2 for n, we'll get 1/2 divided by 2 times 2 minus 1 minus 1/2 over 2 times 2 plus 1. For our first fraction, we'll get 1/2 divided by 4 minus 1 is 3, so that's actually going to give us a 1/6, and then we'll subtract. In the denominator here, we've got 2 times 2, which is 4, plus 1 is 5. 1/2 divided by 5 is 1/10, so that is now, we'll draw parentheses around this, that's now our second term, so 1/6 minus 1/10. And this is going to be n equals 2. Let's just do one more to get an idea. So if we plug in 3, we'll get 1/2 over 2 times 3 minus 1 minus 1/2 divided by 2 times 3 plus 1. In the denominator over here, we'll get 2 times 3, which is 6, minus 1 is 5. 1/2 divided by 5 is 1/10. And then in our denominator here, we'll get 2 times 3, which is 6, plus 1, which is 7. 1/2 divided by 7 is 1/14. So we end up with, for n equals 3, 1/10 minus 1/14. And this is what we get for n equals 3. So at this point, we can start talking about what our series is shaping up to look like. Basically, at this point, what you need to recognize is that as we go out toward infinity, right, plus dot, 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 we're going to end up with this interesting pattern where, notice here, we have negative 1/6 and then we have a positive 1/6. Those two terms will cancel one another. We have a negative 1/10 and a positive 1/10, so those two are going to cancel. If we found the term for n equals 4, we would end up with positive 1/14 minus 1/18, and this 1/14 term would cancel with the next one. And we would be able to continue canceling each of these terms out into infinity. And what that tells us is that all we're left with is the very first half of our first term, 1/2, and therefore that the sum of the series, S sub n, is equal to 1/2, or that the sum of this series is equal to 1/2. And that's really it. So that's our final answer. This is the sum of the telescoping series. So remember, it's really just a matter of performing your partial fractions decomposition, getting this S sub n equation set up with your constants, your A and B constants, your partial fractions decomposition. Then you start plugging in values for n. You see that the series breaks out this way, and you're able to cancel all of the terms except the very first one. And therefore, you know that the sum of your series is just the first term, which in this case is 1/2. So that's it. I really hope this video helped you guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye!